You all hear me now? Marvelous, thank you so much. We are so excited to welcome you to Celtic Holidays matinee performance. That was some of our most advanced dancers you just saw. This show is to mostly highlight our advanced beginner, our beginner, and our intro dancers. So you'll see those guys every so often, and a few of them are doing triple duty, and they're in nearly every dance. It's pretty crazy. But what you're gonna be seeing is a lot of traditional Irish dancing. We have a good mix of solid traditional tunes, along with some very difficult modern dances. When you watch our beginners, you're seeing a student who has practiced something maybe 1,000 times. When you're watching the advanced dancers, you're seeing someone who's practiced it 10,000 times. So it's a pretty amazing feat what you're seeing here tonight. We have dancers as young as 4 or almost 4, and then as old as like a few of us who are not going to tell you how old we are. So you'll be seeing a good mix of hard shoes and soft shoes. My name is Rebecca Ingram. I'll be in and out here explaining what you're seeing. You'll also see Heidi Grigg, but she just finished dancing and she didn't want to be the one to introduce after, you know, that crazy dance right there. So our next dance is going to be Run Run Away. This is to an 80s tune, and the dancers have been working like mad to get this done. This is one of the most difficult hard shoe dances they would do at this level. Watermelon, 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 watermelon. Very steady 4-4 beats. It's very difficult to hold that pattern in hard shoes, so this is their accomplishment for doing an acapella piece this time around.
Thank you.
previous a cappella piece was about 2 weeks ago. It was a very nice surprise. When Becca told me they were going to do an a cappella piece, I thought, oh yeah, they are they? And I was very impressed, which was a relief. Next up, we're going to perform a treble jig. It's at 6/8 timing. This is called Breakout, and is set to music from Michael Flatley's Lord of the Dance.
Thank you.
perform this dance is in, this is really, really random, at the Idaho City Library Fairies and Gnomes Festival. That's usually in June. And here's the fairy reel.
Thank you.
see here today. This is a massive group of eight hands. So you're gonna look for sets of eight through here. This dance is called the Sweets of May. It is one of the oldest dances we're going to be doing here and the oldest soft shoe dance you'll see. This is Irish Ceilidh dance. Ceilidh is spelled C-E-I-L-I. If you're Scottish, it's spelled C-E-I-L-I-D-H. They're cool like that. So when we're lining up for Sweets of May right here, this group over on this side, they're doing something a little extra. Lizette, could you wave at everybody? This side, how many people do you count over here in this group? Could you all wave at everybody really fast? Do we see nine people? So this one is gonna be fun because these guys know the dance so well that they're gonna have somebody extra and they're gonna tag out somebody. They have to jump in the same spot, do the dance in that spot and not mess up a thing. These groups, this is a pro group right here. They're gonna be awesome. The groups on the side, they are gonna be their reference point. So if they go goofy, watch these guys. They're gonna be perfect.
My sisters. My best friend of 11 years, Riley Harvey Sermon, is a senior at Meridian Technical Charter High School. She has been playing the piano for 12 years, and she is an incredibly talented musician. She arranges and composes beautiful, unique pieces of music that are enchanting to have the privilege of listening to. She is a talented artist outside of piano as well, sculpting and creating detailed costumes for all to enjoy. If you're lucky, you might get a glimpse of her as the Grinch around town this holiday season.
Mountains over.
Dance and they performed it beautifully. That was so good, you guys. Our next dance is the family dance. We have Chrissy and Abby leading, and then you get to see who exactly is related to which person with this massive line of us. So we're going to be going from two hands to three hands to four hands to more hands at the back.
Thank you.
back, and that takes some effort. That was tricky. We're getting ready for our next dance. This is a ribbon dance. Normally, Irish dancers don't use props, and we barely ever move our arms. Nobody's quite sure why. It's one of the legends that during a time when Ireland was occupied, the British, when they saw somebody Irish just jumping around, they kept only seeing the top half of them when they were in their farmhouses with the top door removed. So that's one thing. They said they did it to trick the British. Another reason that I've heard is that when you have your arms down at your side, there's less room to swing your hand around and accidentally smack somebody in the face. And for us, we think that's sensible. That sounds right to us. But this one, we changed things up. The dancers are all holding ribbons. Can you guys just like wave your hands to wave ribbons awkwardly? Thank you. This dance is insane. This is one of the most difficult ones. If somebody is slightly out of place, someone's gonna get hit in the face, or the lines will be ruined, or they'll not be able to untangle the knots that they're gonna make as they're doing this dance. So this is incredibly impressive with just one group, but with three, this is pretty unbelievable, and we are very proud of our people. Friction we create when we dance. It's really important to protect our feet. We don't have anything as crazy as pointe shoes for ballet, but if you're looking at, hey Sadie, could you wave at everybody? Some of our more advanced dancers, we have to have extensive padding on the bottom of our feet to be able to do the dances that we do. Hey Adelaide, could you be fancy and go up on your toes carefully for a minute? Because some dancers can dance like that. Thank you, Adelaide. You're crazy. That was beautiful. All right, we are set. This is the square light jig.
Ships come sailing in on Christmas Day. I saw three ships come sailing in on Christmas Day in the morning. And one was in the ships, all three, and everyone came round to see. Thank you.
Shamrock. This is one of our trickiest light jigs. Everybody in this dance has been working to keep lines and hold them. When you're watching this, hopefully we make these lines and formations look fairly simple. It is so difficult. If one person is off, the whole line is off. This dance here has some very difficult formations and very difficult arm movements, so you're going to be watching and looking for lines. And when you see them doing something amazing, please applaud. You'll notice we actually dance bigger the more applause we hear. Expensive, and then they had these different instruments that you had to pay quite a lot for. So one of the things that you would hear typically is called mouth music. So somebody would be using a favorite set of syllables to sing a song. This was really cool because this group combined old mouth music, old mouth singing, with mouth singing. You always sing with your mouth, but what they do is they create a rhythm with it. So this particular one is called diddle-um, because you hear right diddle-diddle-dum, diddle-diddle-diddle-dum, diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle-diddle- slip because we're trying to say harsh. Just go da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da- It's very impressive. These guys have not learned it in 3 months. They've been doing it for years. It's wonderful. They're amazing too. So the two groups together, what we often do is have old dancers that have done it a million times with new dancers who have done it a million times. But this bunch in the corner over on this side over here, they did so well, we actually have a new group and an old group. So you guys can appreciate how they're doing here. This dance is a fun one. This goes from soft shoe into hard shoe. Ready for the dancers to come out. This next dance is Nancy Mulligan. This is an Ed Sheeran song. We actually sped it up, so it's a little bit different than the one on the radio. But this is a favorite. Everybody, could you guys pull up to the second line? Like that far ahead. A little bit closer to that line, then we're set. Emily, you're the best. Everybody line up with Emily. Thank you all so much. All right, this is one of our trickier dances, simply because of the speed and the precision and all the little steps you have to remember. This dance also has some solo steps from the dancers, so they'll be doing some things together and some things individually, but with people. No solos proper, but solo steps, because I understand it's confusing. So we are going to do Jockey to the Fair, and after they finish with this one, they're going to go join a St. Patrick's Day line. And then finally, at the end, you get to see three sea captains. Now, when the traditional dance was created, we actually thought that the choreography was kind of dumb. So while this one's done the same way all over the world, and St. Patrick's Day is done the same way all over the world, three sea captains is very much just on our own. That one's our own choreography. Enjoy.
Thank you.
and at the end, you get to see more lines. It's very important, and one of the most difficult things as an Irish dancer, but this one's even worse. They have to stay in lines, in hard shoes, as well as skip on the beat. It is crazy difficult. We are so proud of them. This group is amazing. Shauna in the back. Matt has been doing our lighting and Shauna's been doing our sound. Could not run the show without them.